And welcome back to North of the Broad. Our final guest for this show is Lisa Sunderla. She is a Museums and Preservation Programs Manager for the Buford Historic Foundation. Lisa, it's good to have you with us. And you're here for a very specific reason. You have an annual meeting coming up later in this month.
We do.
And you have a very important speaker, but let's talk about kind of the agenda for that meeting and then the keynote speaker.
Absolutely. Robin, thank you so much. I appreciate being here today with you. Okay. Our annual meeting is scheduled for March 26th. This is our 54th annual meeting. Mm-hmm. So the foundation has been around for quite a while. And this year we are so excited to have as our keynote speaker Donovan Ripkema. Donovan is the leading economist for preservation in our communities in the nation. And we are just delighted to have him as a part of this meeting. Traditionally, our annual meeting has, of course, the handling of officers at the very beginning of the meeting. Mm-hmm, so that'll be at 5:30. And so that's really open for members. And then at 6, we will launch into our keynote speaker with Donovan.
And is it open to the public?
It is absolutely open to the public. There is a cost, and so for reservations, we encourage people to go to our website at historicbuford.org or to call our office at 843-379-3331.
All right, so let's move on to an initiative, a campaign actually, that's been going on called Paint the Lady in Buford. So let's talk a little bit about that, what that is and what it means to the foundation.
Absolutely. The Lady is the John Mark Vadier House. And it was the John Mark Vadier House that really launched the preservation movement in Buford. Mm-hmm. Back in the 1940s, the building was put up for demolition. And several ladies in the community came together and recognized the importance of it. At that time, it was called the Lafayette House, and recognized the importance of the home and banded together to save the structure. And within a few years, the Historic Buford Foundation was formed out of that effort, which led to the designation of our historic and national landmark historic district.
Wow. One of the things I found interesting in reviewing the notes for our interview today is that the foundation provides these educational programs, workshops for contractors, architects, builders, which I think is so important and to this area. So what great outreach, and talk a little bit more about that.
Actually, and if I could back up for 1 second with the Paint the Lady campaign, we are seeking donations to help us paint the structure. Okay. And we need to raise up to 300,000. We have 150, and so we are looking for more donations for that.
Good.
Regarding our education programs, we have launched this year a number of education programs for local property owners, developers, and residents. Mm-hmm. We partnered with the City of Buford on these and also the State Archives and History. We had a very successful program 2 weeks ago on historic tax credits offered for improvement to properties, and we're hoping to do more this year.
Right. So Lisa, I'm interested, we've got about a minute and a half left, I'm interested in you and in how you got involved in historic preservation. Is that your background?
Yes.
Is it with your degree in that? I mean, it's fascinating, so important, obviously, for this area.
Absolutely, absolutely. My undergraduate degree is in art history and sociology from Converse College, but I went on to Middle Tennessee State to get a master's in American history and historic preservation, and started out first here in Buford as director of the Main Street program in the 80s and 90s.
Oh, wow.
At the same time, our current director, Cynthia Jenkins of Historic Buford Foundation, was the first paid director for a Historic Buford Foundation in the 80s and 90s. So both of us have come back to the community and are so excited to be a part of this new team at the foundation.
Wonderful. Again, the annual meeting is on March the 26th at 6 o'clock for the public. Mm-hmm. Officers and kind of the executive committee will be meeting prior to that. And you can go on the website.
Yes, and for tickets.
For
absolutely.
Tickets.
And we do have our architects tour this weekend as well, too.
Yes.
So we encourage folks to get involved.
Thank you so much. Appreciate you being with us. And that's it for this show, North of the Broad. We'll see you next time.